I have this pretty complicated part. It's probably a medical part. It's a handle of some sort, I think. It has little pieces that stick out here. It has lots of little bosses that are probably screw bosses. Has little holes in the back here. Very difficult part to mold. I'm gonna make a two-part silicone mold of this and make duplicates. And I make a special tool to help me demold the parts, so you wanna stick around till the end for that.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. Alfred Backpack Hanger in stainless steel and aluminum, designed by me, holds your backpack, lets you charge your phone, holds your keys. Super versatile. So I'm packing up some here that were recently sold. They're all packaged up in earth-friendly cardboard boxes. I put a little note on them and it goes off to the customer. Thanks for those of you who've purchased recently. It really helps support the channel. I cleaned the part with a little bit of denatured alcohol. I think there's some residual glue left on the handle here. Always just a good idea to clean your part before you cast it. The part is not sealable to a bottom surface, so it needs some clay to clay and dam up the ends so that we can pour silicone around the part. Little known fact here, I used a clay model for Ford back in the day. Yeah, wow, did not like that job. Thankfully, I don't do that anymore. I'm modeling some little keys here just to make sure with the alignment. Also, I laser cut my locking keys here to lock the silicone molds together once they're made. And we're gonna glue the part down with some PVA here, just some white glue and a little weight to hold it in place while it dries. Now you'll notice there's extra clay on the one end of this handle. And that's because there are little plastic tabs that stick out. So I need some extra space there to put some vents in so that I can mold those parts. Otherwise, that's going to be an impossible thing. I'd have to make a three-part mold, which I don't want to do, and that will become a little more evident as we move forward. I'm using silicone inks 1040. This is a 40 Shore A silicone. It's what I use every day when I'm making silicone molds. Very versatile, flexible, durable silicone that I like using for making my molds. I'll put the silicone in the vacuum tank. Probably takes 15 to 20-ish minutes to degas this volume of silicone. It's probably about 500 milliliters to 700 milliliters of silicone here. And you pour in from one spot and you let it flow out so that there are no trapped air bubbles in your mold. Let that cure at room temperature overnight and it'll be good to go. All right, at some point I came to the conclusion that I was gonna have to take the part out of the mold, something that I don't like to do. But there was so much intricate detail here that scooping out all the little remnants of clay was not gonna be possible inside the mold. So I took the part out. It's something I don't recommend. You really wanna leave the thing in there so you get a good seal. I'm using some mineral spirits to clean up the clay. This will soften or melt the clay so I can just wipe it away. and we'll take the master part and we'll put it back into the first half of the silicone mold. I'm going to use a piece of tape, clear tape, to block off the holes in between the two parts, the part on the left and the cavity on the right. And this is just so I don't have to come back and cut the silicone with an X-Acto or a blade after it's been poured. This will allow the two halves of the pour to separate. Here I'm putting on my vents, and I'm doing that with cyanoacrylate, and I'm dipping my brush in some accelerant or some kicker so it sets up right away. There's about 20 vents here, and then my one big pour sprue in the middle. And here I'm applying release agent, which is about 70% naphtha and 30% Vaseline onto the silicone so that I can separate the two halves. For the second half of the mold, I'm using Smooth-On's Mold Max 20. This is a Shore 20A silicone. It's pretty soft stuff, but there's some pretty wicked undercuts. And I felt that the 40 durometer silicone was going to be too hard or too stiff, and I wanted something softer. The Smooth-On stuff is something that I can get locally, that I can literally drive to and get some, and so it's very convenient, so I'm using it. Otherwise, I would order something, but I didn't have anything on hand, so we're using the Smooth-On stuff. And I'll leave a link to that below. I am an Amazon affiliate, so anything you buy in my Amazon store helps me and the channel make more content in the future. Try to pour from one location and let the silicone flow out so it basically pushes the air out of the way and reduces the chance of having any trapped air inside of your mold. You did all this work, you don't want to trap the air. Let it cure overnight, and we should have a nice two-part mold. All right, did all this work. It's time to separate the two halves of the silicone mold. We'll remove the mold box, and then we'll remove the vents and the pour sprue. This is a time-consuming process, takes a little while, comes apart. Some of the silicone has spilled out into the bottom of the blue area, not a big deal, I just cut it. And then we'll go through and gently pry everything apart. I have a little bit of a connection in the one part, and I have to cut that with a knife, not a big deal. Comes apart, and we'll take the master part out here. And we will be ready to put the molds back together and make some parts. All right, I'm going to use a little bit of Smooth-On Smoothcast 305. This resin is readily available for me, meaning I can just drive to the store and go and get some. Sets up fairly quickly and easy to use, easy to degas. We'll degas this in the vacuum tank. Takes a minute and a half to degas it. It's degassed pretty much right now, and now you're just pulling CO2 out of the resin. And we'll pour it into the mold through a half of a syringe, and it's on top of my dental vibration tool. And that vibration allows the resin to flow through the mold even better. And it's tipped so that we're pouring in the low spot and the resin comes out of the high spot. Once the resin has filled up all the vents to the top, I lay it flat, and then this is how it will cure. All right, I can demold this resin in about 3 hours, and now it's time. You have to remove all the vents first, and I'll use my little blue needle nose pliers here. And I'm having a really tough time grabbing the round vents with the pliers that are basically flat, and I'm unable to sort of grab them, and I have a lot of them to grab. So I'm gonna make a special tool that's gonna help me remove all the little vents from the part. So the concept here is that I'm gonna make the inside of these pliers round so that they can grip onto the vents. And I use a Dremel tool to grind away these flat pliers on the inside. And then I'm gonna smooth out the outside so that they're cylindrical on the outside, so I can reach the pliers in around that tube and pull them out of the silicone one by one and get a good grip on them.
So these pliers are rounded so they can easily grip onto these vents, and then I can twist the part and pull it out. Very easy. I should have made these pliers a long, long time ago. It really makes the job much, much easier.
And you can see how much easier these pliers work to pull all the vents out of the silicone. It works great. Very pleased. All right, let's pull the part out. The soft silicone is working pretty nice for some of these undercuts in the area here. There's a little bit of flash. That's pretty minimal, but the detail parts all came out. Little holes on the end and the little pins in the front. It's not too bad. There's a little tiny air bubbles right there on the bottom. Yeah, but not too bad. All right, I need to go make 7 more of these. Hope you enjoyed the video. Good luck on your casting projects. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Make sure to hit the bell so you get notifications every time I have a new video. Also, don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Links in the description below and on the channel page. Rock on. Don't forget to check out the t-shirts and hoodies in the merch shelf below. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.